This is Lincoln, the channel for Higher Self. The following video clip features an audio segment from a Higher Self channeling session that I had with a member of this YouTube audience. During this session, I was asked questions to describe the Higher Self experience and other related topics, such as meditating upon the spiritual heart, the current ascension and 2012 experiences happening within humanity, deeper insights into the mind, emotions, the state of meditation, and many other topics that relate to these channel Higher Self videos. The following video is one clip of 37 separate videos organized according to topics. The total video time is over 2 hours and 20 minutes. You can find a list of these video topics along with their respective links on the sidebar to the YouTube video and also in the description on the on my channel Higher Self website. So I'd like to thank you for taking part in these Higher Self videos with me, and I would like to wish you many blessings and much love within your life. Namaste. And then we can step even further into a self that is beyond individuation. It's beyond causality. It's beyond personal experience and personal identification. And that's the experience of the higher self. That's the experience of pure consciousness, of pure love, of pure wisdom, and pure creative power. These three qualities, love, wisdom, and power, have been given to the higher self by many different teachers. And it more or less recognizes that all of our creativity, all of our experience, comes from this source that exists everywhere and flows throughout all life. And that is the higher self. So we can feel love, and the love is a manifestation of the higher self. We can have wisdom or have knowledge, and that's from the higher self. And we can have creative energy, which is from the higher self. And we see this in our lives in every moment, that we are creators, that we have the possibility of knowing love or gaining knowledge. Yet when we step into the experience of the higher self, it's a different, it's a more expanded experience of these three qualities. The love becomes unconditional. As a personal being, as a person in this world, we believe that our experience of love must be conditioned by some experiences. So we must gain something, or we must interact with another person in order to experience love. Whereas in the higher self, love simply exists as the experience. It's unconditional. There's no cause, there's no effect. It simply just is at all times. That is one way to know when we've gone deep enough into our own higher self, that we just experience love, and there's no reason for the love, it simply is. With knowledge in our world, we gain knowledge as we go through experience. However, the higher self has access to knowledge from its own perspective, which is outside of causality. It's outside of cause and effect. So we can access this knowledge, and it'll help us in our individual lives. But it does not come from any experiences we go through. Oftentimes in our own life, we may have insight or knowledge that is brand new to us, and we've never read it, we've never heard it spoken to us by another person, yet we know it very deeply within ourself. Oftentimes that comes from the higher self. It can also come from the soul. It's one of these unshakable, undeniable knowings that we have that cannot be explained by any of our experiences in the material world. So as we enter into a greater experience of the higher self, we learn that we can really use this greater universal knowledge for our own benefit, not in a selfish benefit, but in a way to better understand ourselves, to better understand our experiences in this world. The higher self is in an alignment with the experience of love. So all knowledge that comes from the higher self will be that of love. There will be no knowledge that will teach us to cause harm, that will teach us to create evil, that will encourage us to act out of greed. Everything from the higher self is rooted in love. So when a person says that they got knowledge and it's encouraging them to hurt somebody or kill somebody, it's not coming from the higher self, because the higher self is love.
That type of knowledge will be coming from a different source. In most cases, that's another being, or that's a subconscious aspect of that person that is in pain or suffering that is causing these thoughts and motivations that are self-destructive. The third aspect of the higher self is the creative power, and it is really is a pure creative energy that flows through all life. We can see this working in small amounts in our own life when we choose to practice manifestation or really create anything. It's the energy that causes movement and activity and action. And the more deeply we connect to the creative power of the higher self, the more we realize that the creative power is not affected nor bound by time. So if we choose to have an experience and we connect with this deep aspect of ourself, the experience can be created instantly. Now, most people are not able to deeply enough connect to the higher self where it becomes an instant manifestation, because it does take practice and a really strong connection to work outside the laws of three-dimensional manifest time. However, there are beings throughout history who have done this, who've been able to manifest things instantly, and it's been called magic in some cases, or it's been kept hidden from the public because it would draw too much attention. But in our own lives, we can still use this creative power, and it'll just take a little more time. It might take a day, it might take a week. Depending on the magnitude of what we're choosing to create, it could take a few years, because the arrangement of elements, the arrangement of experiences in this world, have to align themselves to bring about that which we wish to create. So the more command we have over the elements of this world, the more quickly we can manifest that which we desire. And just because something takes longer time for us to manifest doesn't at all change the fact that we are connected to this source of creative energy. So it's really just a matter of learning to more deeply connect to the higher self, to more deeply have access to this ability to manifest and to create. And again, the creative power that comes from the higher self, it's a little different than the creative power of the ego. The creative power from the higher self is in alignment with love and with knowledge or wisdom. So the creative energy will flow in that direction. It will cause things that create more love. The creative energy will cause things that are in alignment with our highest good, with the highest knowledge that we have. So people who are choosing to say, who are choosing to manifest out of greed or out of a belief in separation, that is a universal creative energy that they're using, but it's being directed by the ego and it's not being directed by the higher self. So that's a key difference when learning to manifest. Are we choosing to manifest based on our creative power in alignment with the higher self, which is in alignment with love, with selflessness, with knowledge that we have? Or are we choosing to use our creative abilities to manifest selfish things, to create experiences that will cause suffering in this world, or even to create experiences that will not serve the universal good of all of life? So those are the three main aspects of the higher self, and as you choose to more deeply connect with them, you will come to a greater understanding that you are not at all separate from this.